let's start with the Megan Fox story, guys. Let's just, like, dive into it. Okay. Megan Fox and MGK, Machine Gun Kelly, just got engaged. They've been drinking each other's blood. They've been having this really interesting relationship where they explain it as twin flames. This idea, according to Megan, that, like, they're two souls that got separated into two different bodies and they finally met up again. She said that it's been chaotic and passionate, that it's been very difficult and hard. And what's crazy is that as I'm reading their stories, I, in conjunction with finding this woman on TikTok that made me literally laugh so hard, because yes, girl, she made this whole TikTok series about how she thinks the longer and more dramatic the Instagram posts are of a couple, the more likely they are to end up breaking up. And MGK and Megan Fox are no exception. They're very like, it's been, this 1 year has been so hard. I didn't know the challenges this relationship would cause me to face. And I just, like, want to say to them, your first year of dating is normally your honeymoon stage, and it was your hardest stage. And then my second question slash comment is, like, when do we grow up? What does growing up look like? Megan Fox was married previously and had three kids. I think they're all under the age of 15 with another man. She had a life that I thought was going to be stable for her, a life outside of Hollywood, a life where she could grow up. But the funny thing is that we all know, like Trisha Paytas and many people in Hollywood, they have been stunted and have remained adolescent. I think a lot of us got invested in Megan Fox's story because we thought she was going to have her moment after Me Too and Transformers and the abuse she had in Hollywood. We really thought she was going to get better. Funny, I talked to one of my brothers yesterday and he goes, oh, fuck Megan Fox. She's such a cunt. Do you know she manipulated everyone on that set of Transformers and completely, like, took advantage of everybody? I was like, funny, because in my circles, we talk about how she got taken advantage of. But the thing is, now that she's with MGK, a part of me is like, were you the cunt after all? Because MGK and Megan, like, together, like, Megan choosing MGK tells me that she's not respectable in the way that I thought she could have ended up. And this is what I mean to say. Who you choose as your partner could mean many things and nothing. But for those people who live in bubbles, it does mean something traditionally. Much greater. But I think everyone in particular does say something. So MGK is a person who holds no respect for the people who've come before him. He's disrespectful to the rap community. He's disrespectful to Eminem. He's disrespectful in a lot of ways. He's narcissistic on a very high scale. But maybe so is she. I mean, she's been literally praised as that bitch her whole life, right? So I think a lot of us need to understand that this, like, emo, drama-filled, teenage love they're having is real and authentic and necessary for their story, but it's something that many of us, I believe, should outgrow. And I think they should too, but I also only think that because I know that based off what they've told me about their own relationship, it sounds too hard. It sounds like a lot of pain, and it sounds like a lot of, like, self-inflicted pain on each other. And I don't think that's healthy. And I don't think that that's personally how I see healthy relationships. Now, people can disagree with me. If you want a relationship that involves fighting with your partner or yelling at your partner, like, that's your business. But I don't think it's healthy. And I have been there. And I realized in that moment that it was happening, like, holy fuck, I'm white trash. Like, I'm Middle Eastern white trash. Like, I am trash. Like, I'm a ghetto ass couple that's yelling at each other at 3 a.m. in the morning. And I'm supposed to think this is healthy. Healthy and beautiful and real love because we feel this strong chemistry towards each other. Fuck no. Like, I don't want my partner to ever be somebody that I would ever be able to stomach thinking so ill of. But at the same time, if at the same time you want to have a transparent and honest and hard, not hard, but sometimes life can be difficult when you're intimate with someone and it can get hard. And then you're going to have those ugly conversations. But I think during those ugly conversations, how you treat your partner matters, right? What I mean to say when I say karma is that your life is a reflection of what you've put into it, but not in a tangible, I put $50 into this bank account and I got $50 back. But more like, certain people have a certain way that they exist in the world, and it's because of, like, who they are. And I think that that's something you should dive into. When I ask you, who are you and who are the people who are going to see you? I'm not asking you your name, Alice. When Alice says, I'm Alice, like when the caterpillar says, like, who are you? And Alice goes, I'm Alice. He's like, motherfucker, that's not what I'm asking you. I'm not asking you your name someone gave you. I'm asking you who you are. What the fuck are you doing with your life? And who do you think you are that you get to run a narrative in your head that woe is me, or everyone sucks but me, everyone's loyal but me, everyone's perfect but me? Are you not making choices to add that energy into your life? And then you wonder why that energy comes back at you. Megan Fox is with a man who is so disrespectful and holds no respect or dignity. And then she's going to turn around in 5 years and be like, I did not see this coming. And I'm like, oh, really, girl? You didn't learn your lesson? And no. So the universe is once again giving her a new one. How can they get married after a year? What are you doing? Like, what are you doing? Like, and I mean that in the nicest way possible. But normally, if you get out of a relationship, you should have a span of time. Look at Melani. What's his name? John Mulaney and Olivia, whatever her fucking name is. Like, all these, like, gossip stories. Look at, like, Chloe and all the basketball players. And look at all these, like, all these people that are just, like, in a cycle of, like, continuing their idiocracy. And then they sit around and go, how is this happening? And I'm like... And it's like the world is giving you lessons and you're not being introspective. But also, there's a consequence in their bubble to being introspective.
What's my sun sign?
Your sun is Taurus. Your moon is Pisces. Your rising is Gemini. You have a stellium of planets in Pisces. Your sun is in the 12th house, which is the house that's ruled by Neptune, which is the ruler of Pisces. You're very Piscean and you're very Gemini. Very morose, and the moods are very intense. But I know the whole chart.
Okay, well, obviously you win this game, but we're gonna finish this out just for the people.